Good evening and delighted to be here with you. Wish you all a happy November. With every month we are moving out of the COVID fear, out of the lockdown, because we are doing things responsibly with a lot of awareness, but we are not scared. Of course, we are responsible, because for any situation to come out victorious out of any situation, I think responsibility is one thing that is really, really important. And another thing that is really, really important is the right knowledge. So today I am responsibly sharing the right knowledge with you. And today's knowledge is about laser hair reduction, also known as permanent laser hair reduction. And I am going to be answering two very important questions that people have asked me, the most common and the most relevant questions that people have asked me about a laser hair reduction. So in the next 30 minutes, you are going to get two powerful answers. And yes, they are not yes, no answers. You know that I am going to explain you exactly why I say this, so that you have crystal clear understanding of how a laser works and whether it is right for you. So I have seen that in this lockdown, a lot of people were asking me the ways of getting rid of unwanted hair, especially when they couldn't go to the salon for their bleaching or waxing. They wanted to know what else is possible. Is it okay to shave? Do those hair removal creams make your skin dark? So there were so many questions that came up, and that was when I realized that getting rid of unwanted hair is a problem to so many people. And I did not understand why they did not go for a very, very simple solution, which is permanent hair reduction using lasers. So there are so many people who are contemplating permanent hair reduction using lasers, but they are not going for it. But according to me, it's a very, very smart thing to do, because imagine, from the age of 16 or 17, those of you who have to get rid of unwanted hair are visiting the salon or using any other modality as much as once in 3 weeks or once in 4 weeks. So in a year, more than 12 times you need to invest time and money getting rid of unwanted hair. Also, it is on your mind all the time. You have to be concerned about where you're going, what you're wearing, and whether it is going to look unhygienic or unclean because of the unwanted hair. So I know that it can be a background irritant for many people, something that is eating into your otherwise productive days. In fact, the hair removal that people do, it doesn't eat into their productive days, because obviously people are not making trips to the parlors on their work days. It unfortunately eats into the weekends, the little time that people find for themselves, the little time that people find to chill out. So I would rather want you to spend that weekend on a nice massage. I would want you to spend that weekend doing things you love and totally rejuvenating yourself, and not have to schedule that salon appointment on the weekend because you want to get rid of the unwanted hair. Because unwanted hair can be got rid of permanently, and why wouldn't you do that? So everybody has to get rid of some kind of unwanted hair, some on the face and some on the body. For a lot of females, because polycystic ovarian syndrome is very, very common, so a lot of females have unwanted facial hair, and it is a basic hygiene factor. It is absolutely not acceptable for them to go out with that unwanted facial hair, so they need to find some way to get rid of it. So between the age of 15, when a female is hormonally active, to the age of maybe 65, till she is still socializing and wanting to look good, they are doing something to get rid of unwanted hair. So that is so many years and so many times and so much of hassle and bother on the mind to keep repeatedly doing something like this. Wouldn't you want to look for a permanent solution? So the permanent solution is a laser hair reduction, better known as a permanent laser hair reduction. And I know that a lot of people are not taking the decision of laser hair reduction because they have a few questions which are unanswered. And I am going to answer these questions today and on Thursday, both at 9 o'clock. I have dedicated 2 half an hour sessions to laser hair reduction. I have dedicated all of November to ask me anything about laser hair reduction because I want you to know all the answers, and I am sure that when you know all the answers, then you are empowered to take the right decision. You are empowered to find the right solution that fits you, and the right solution definitely saves you time and money. The right solution saves you a lot of hassle too. So jumping into the two questions that I'm going to answer today, two questions are, is laser hair reduction permanent? So when I talk about laser hair reduction and when I say that, why can't you get rid of your hair permanently? In fact, I was thinking about a lot of men. So even though men have to shave their facial hair for men does not undergo laser hair reduction because at some point of time they may want to grow a beard or a mustache. So it is not common to go for facial laser hair reduction for men. Men go for laser hair reduction in the pinna because some men have hair coming out of their ears and that looks absolutely hideous, and the men are getting rid of it permanently. Men go for laser hair reduction in this upper cheekbone area sometimes because some men are hairy here and that does not look nice at all. So there is one more area where men can go for laser hair reduction. Men can also go for laser hair reduction in the area in between. They have something called as a unibrow. So some men have both the eyebrows joined. Yes, it happens in females too. Females undergo laser hair reduction in many, many parts because for a female, if she has facial hair, she can get rid of it permanently. But for a man, for a facial hair, the beard area is not regularly done. What is done is the unibrow, the area here, hair on the ears. So this is areas where men get laser hair reduction done. One area where men should explore getting laser hair reduction done is an underarm area. Very, very popular among females. Females are queuing up to get their underarm laser hair reduction done because it is such a relief, but men are still using methods like shaving. I would just like to open up this conversation and want you, if you're a female, talk to the men in your life because definitely it saves you a lot of time, it saves you a lot of money, it saves you a lot of hassle, and it keeps you a lot more hygienic. The area around underarms, if it is kept clean all the time, you can imagine how much more clean, fresh and hygienic you feel. You do not feel as sweaty as you otherwise feel if your underarms are not clean. Also, repeated shaving, repeated waxing, repeated hair removal creams in any area causes irritation to the area. So repeatedly going for these procedures causes a subtle inflammation, and this inflammation happening again and again many times does not cause the proper healing, and people have dark underarms. So then if your underarms look clean, how much nicer does it look to you? Because most of us are wearing all kind of clothes, and why not? Today the world is opening up, people are being comfortable in their own skin, and people are wearing different kind of clothes. Most people are wearing sleeveless clothes. And then if your underarms look too dark or your underarm looks patchy, it's not going to look good at all. So I would want both men and women to ask me questions regarding underarm laser hair reduction because I want to empower you to do fun things in life, and I want to make sure that you have a lot of time, not just to increase your productivity. So I'm surrounded by a lot of ambitious and proactive people and people who are super productive. So I do not really need to give the productivity lesson to people, but I would still be very, very happy if people take out time for themselves and do not spend their me time, which they so love, rushing to a salon just to remove the unwanted hair. So if you are not going for laser hair reduction because you have a few questions unanswered, I am going to answer these questions for you. So I am Dr. Shweta Iyengar, if you do not know me yet, and I am the founder and the thought leader of Aesthetic Clinic Skin Sense. At Aesthetic Clinic Skin Sense, we use globally proven advanced medical therapies and ensure that you are awesome inside out, you are healthy on the inside, and because you are healthy on the inside, you look absolutely amazing on the outside. You have beautiful skin, beautiful hair, and a beautiful body shape. This is what we stand for. I am on a mission to educate people. with the right knowledge, because there is an abundance of knowledge available, but this abundance of knowledge, when not simplified and explained, is causing a lot of overwhelm, and overwhelm is causing a lot of inaction. And I know for a fact that the only thing that can change the world is action. So I want to empower you to take the action and take the right action in the direction of your goals. And of course, people will have different goals, and which is what makes the world so beautiful, people having so many different goals. But there is one goal which is common to all of us, and that goal which is common to all of us is all of us want to be happy. So Neetu, I feel happy that you've joined this live. Hi Neetu. So we are talking about laser hair reduction, and we are talking about human goals, where every goal has another ultimate goal: to feel happy, to fulfill your innermost needs and desires, to fulfill your innermost feelings. And everybody today feels that I need time to do things that may not make any sense that I absolutely love doing. So everybody is craving for free time. Life has got very busy. After using so much of WhatsApp, there is always somebody waiting for you to answer back something, and you're feeling so overwhelmed about having number of things to do. And I want you to save time wherever possible by making smart choices. So laser, of course, it saves you money also, because even though you may be spending very little every time you go for a bleach or every time you go for a wax, but imagine the number of times you're doing it over a lifetime. For almost 30 years, a woman is undergoing some kind of unwanted hair removal procedure. So a month after month, sometimes even more than a month. So it is definitely a royal waste of time. We've never really spent time thinking about it. It's become a part of our habit, and we feel it doesn't matter, it doesn't take too much time, it doesn't cost too much. But if you sum up all the time, and if you sum up all the money you're spending in these other temporary techniques of hair reduction, you will know that laser is definitely a smarter choice, and it saves you money. But beyond saving you money, it saves you time, and I value time a lot. It's a beautiful world. There's so much more we can do with our time. Why do repeated activities when there are permanent solutions? And more important than anything else, it frees you of the hassle. Otherwise, there will be a parallel track in your head that, oh, this weekend I need to fix an appointment to remove my unwanted hair. But when you choose a laser, all that you have to do is 8 to 12 times you need to visit the clinic, 8 to 12 times you need to invest time to remove your unwanted hair. The unwanted area of the hair can be raised around 12 times, 8 to 12 times in fact, and in 8 to 12 times you will see that you have an absolutely clean area, an area which looks hygienic, where there is no visible hair. And because there is no visible hair, you feel confident wearing anything on any day. So thank you, Neetu, for saying that you look beautiful. And I have told you a couple of times too that you look beautiful too. You're a gorgeous woman, and I am looking forward to meet you very, very soon. So the two questions that I'm going to answer today. So the first question is it permanent? So the answer to this is yes, it is permanent, but it is called as a laser hair reduction. So hear me carefully, it's not called as a laser hair removal, but it is called as a laser hair reduction, which means that the hair does not completely go away, the hair does not die completely. There is still some hair left, which is almost visible, invisible to naked eyes. So the hair gets so minuscule, the hair gets so weak, it goes to the level of being a vellus hair. A vellus hair is like a baby hair, it's not a thick hair. So it becomes so minuscule that it is invisible to the naked eye across social distance. So we are meeting most people across social distance, and when they see you across social distance, they will not be able to see the hair, because the hair has become very minuscule, the hair has become very, very thin, it's almost invisible, and it is incapable of growing under normal circumstances. So yes, the hair reduction definitely happens in both men and women, whichever part they may choose. And this hair reduction is very, very effective. It actually frees you from the embarrassment of looking hairy in unwanted areas. But yes, if you put the person under a microscope, you will see that some hair exists. So there's a difference between this skin, there's a difference between this skin, and there's a difference between a skin of a person who is bald. So you can compare this skin of mine with a skin, or you can compare my forehead with somebody who has lost hair and who is bald and who does not have any follicles, and you will exactly know what I'm saying, that in a hair reduction there is no visible hair but there is still hair. But if you are talking about a complete elimination of hair, you know, it looks very different. The skin doesn't look healthy with complete elimination of hair. Skin looks beautiful with invisible but small vellus hair. So that is something that I want to tell you, that yes, laser hair reduction works. Yes, laser hair reduction is permanent, but then it is just a reduction. So if you go very, very close, if you put a microscope or if you put a spotlight on the face and you look very, very closely, you will be able to see small, small hair, which are vellus hair, which are going to exist. It's not going to be very, very thick. It's not going to be all over the area, but some hair are going to exist even after you complete all the sessions of laser hair reduction. But you need not worry about this, because if you are thinking, what's the point if some hair is going to exist? I just want to tell you that this hair is not visible across social distance to the naked eye. So this is not going to require you to use any technology like an epilator or a waxing or a threading. You have to do nothing about it. You can just ignore it and you can just look as clean and as beautiful as you want to be. So you can go for a laser hair reduction even after knowing that it's not removal, it's reduction, but it still serves you and it still justifies the purpose. Now, why am I bringing this up? Because it is reduction, under normal circumstances, the hair is not going to grow back. But in special circumstances where you have a hormonal problem, where you put on a lot of weight around the abdomen, sometimes the testosterone in the body, which is the male hormone, so you might know that males also have female hormones in the body and females also have male hormones in the body. That is the reason if the amount of testosterone in a female body goes out of proportion, suddenly increases because of some fibroids in the uterus, because of polycystic ovarian syndrome, because of some kind of tumors, because of accumulating a lot of fat around the tummy area where the uterus is, then people start seeing that this hair, which has been laced, sometimes starts regrowing. That is the reason some people say that despite doing laser hair reduction, I still see some hair growing. Of course, it is very, very less hair that grows, and then those people will have to have a better lifestyle, they will have to get their hormone under control, and they can take some more sessions of the laser hair reduction and get rid of this problem. So it's not such a big deal. Assuming you get your laser sessions done and after 3 to 5 years, God forbid, because of some kind of a hormonal change, because when we are talking about 5 to 10 years of our life, especially when I'm talking about a female in reproductive age, a lot of changes happen in that time. A lot of times females get pregnant and they put on weight, and sometimes they take hormonal pills for certain things, and because of not treating the body properly, maybe because of stress, maybe because of bad diet habits, or maybe because of hormones, today it is very rampant that a lot of females are having increased testosterone. A lot of females are having some kind of a hormonal imbalance, and even after a laser, in 5 to 7 years, sometimes we see females have to come back for a couple of sessions, 2 or 3 sessions, because their hair has started regrowing. And I think that's not a cause of concern at all, because it's just fine. Imagine you get freedom for 5 to 7 years, after which you might have to take, less than 10% of the people might have to take 2-3 sessions to get rid of the hair that is growing again. I think that's not too much to ask. Because if you are having to go to the parlor for repeated threading or waxing, you know what a pain it is. Imagine if you get freedom for life, how amazing is that? And if you get the second best, you get freedom for a couple of years and then you have to repeat 1 or 2 sessions. I'm sure that's not asking for too much. So at this channel where I will be talking to you Instagram at 9 on Tuesdays and Thursdays. You can get the most curated information, you can get the most honest information, and I will answer your questions, the questions which are in your mind. I take a lot of time understanding your needs, desires and problems, and I come up with simplified solutions for your needs, desires and problems, and I will be answering it as it is. No yes, no answers, no depends answers. I will exactly tell you what you need to know, and I will also tell you why I am saying this, so that you have crystal clear understanding of what we are talking about. We will talk about what you need to know, and with this crystal clear understanding, you can take an informed decision. And you know that an informed decision always works better, and an informed decision also keeps you stress-free. Now, quickly, in the next 10 minutes, we are talking about PCOS or PCOD. You all of us have heard about PCOS or PCOD. In fact, we have somebody in the family who has PCOS or PCOD, or we have somebody in our friend circle. So it's become like a household term called as polycystic ovarian disease or polycystic ovarian syndrome, seen only in females. And these females have a hormonal imbalance where testosterone, which is the male hormone, is increased, and because of which they have a condition called as hirsutism. In hirsutism, females have hair like men. So females have hair on their upper lip, females have hair on their chin, their side locks, all over the face there is some hair. Some females also have hair on their bodies like men, and this actually, their self-esteem gets affected with this kind of a hair, and they need to go for hair removal. But then some females feel that, since I have a polycystic ovarian syndrome, is it the right time for me to go for laser hair reduction? Because this hormonal problem will not allow me to get the optimum results in laser hair reduction, and I will be wasting my time and money doing this. And I want to give you a very, very smart answer for this. I'm calling myself smart, which is right, but after I give you my point of view, you will agree with me that this is a smart way of thinking, because polycystic ovarian disease, it takes time to treat the problem. It takes 3 to 5 years to treat the problem unless you are extremely disciplined. Of course, people have got rid of it in 6 months also. Some people have taken 18 months. So I do not want to kind of scare you, or I do not want to put any kind of negative beliefs in you. But I am just telling you, because as human beings and doing so many things, most of us lack on discipline, and polycystic ovarian syndrome cannot be treated by medicines alone. It will require a change in lifestyle, because of which people keep going yo-yo. People do not get the results that easily, and it may take 3 to 5 years of dedication to get rid of this syndrome completely. But I do want to tell you that yes, so many people, in fact increasingly people, have got rid of their polycystic ovarian syndrome, and you can too. So if you're listening to this video, and if you have polycystic ovarian syndrome, and if you're frustrated that you've tried everything and nothing works for you, let me tell you that things will work. Just be committed. It takes time, but you will definitely get the results, and you will be free of polycystic ovarian syndrome. So in these 3 to 5 years, when you have polycystic ovarian syndrome, you have a lot of hirsutism, what I said, unwanted hair in certain parts, which definitely makes you feel unclean and which makes you feel embarrassed. And then going for temporary methods just because you have polycystic ovarian syndrome, according to me, is not a good idea. Because even if a normal person needs 8 sessions of lasers, somebody with a polycystic ovarian syndrome may need 12 to 15 sessions of lasers. But I think it is still worth it, because it gives them the freedom from hair. Once they start the lasers, in as little as 3 sessions, they will start seeing that the thickness of hair dramatically decreases, the number of hair dramatically decreases, and the time for the regrowth of hair, the span starts increasing. And as it starts increasing, there are longer and longer periods of hair when you are hair free, And that is so much of a blessing, that is so much of a respite for these people, because most of them are teenagers and most of them are extremely busy with their career. They're extremely busy with trying to do something and they do not want to pay attention to this nagging problem, which is worthless actually. It is worthless to invest your time again and again, repeatedly doing the same things. So then I would want to tell you that even if your results are going to be a little less, because yes, in polycystic ovarian syndrome, since the testosterone is higher, the regrowth of the hair is much faster. So if you compare the laser hair reduction results in somebody who does not have polycystic ovarian syndrome and somebody who has a polycystic ovarian syndrome, there is a difference. But despite the difference being there, it is still worth it, even if you have to spend a little more and take 15 sessions or 12 sessions instead of the 8 sessions that your friend without the polycystic ovarian syndrome is taking. I would still tell you it is still worth it, even if your hair comes back, because you are not able to hormonally balance yourself and you have to repeat a couple of sessions, maybe 3 to 5 sessions. After 3 to 5 years, it is still worth it, because a laser hair reduction is not very expensive, not time consuming, not painful. And even if you have to repeat it a couple of times, all you lose is a few rupees extra. But think about it, how much of hassle it saves you, how much of time it saves you, and how much it allows you to focus on the things that really matter. So a lot of problems, especially hormonal problems, one of the main reasons for hormonal problems is stress, and then adding to these repeated things where you have to plan every weekend about hair removal, I think this definitely adds to the stress of people. So let me de-stress you a little by inviting you to a laser hair reduction session at SkinSense. Ask me anything about laser hair reduction, effective in both men and women, effective in every person, even if you have a hormonal imbalance. Is it permanent? Yes, it is permanent if your hormones are extremely balanced, but if your hormones undergo too much of upheavals, the hair might come back, because a lot of people casually call it the laser hair removal, but the hair is not removed, it is just reduced. The vellus hair are still there, and whenever the body has too much of testosterone, the vellus hair may start growing back. But if it starts growing back, all it takes is one or two sessions to make it not grow again, make it vellus again. So it's as simple as that. So I've enjoyed being here for these 30 minutes and answering your questions. There are certain other questions regarding laser hair reduction, which I'm sure you want answers to, like how many sessions do you need? Is it painful? At what age can we start? Are there any contraindications? Is it that it will not work for somebody? And I will like to answer all the remaining questions. Write your questions to me, because I show up to answer your questions and to empower you to take the right choice. So Neetu, I think the highlight of today's live was that you came up, and like I said earlier, I can't wait to see you. Looking forward to see you again on Thursday. Anybody who thinks that somebody has a hair reduction problem, somebody is complaining about unwanted facial or body hair, whether it be male or female, you can share this post with them, because people do need the right knowledge. It is our responsibility to share the right knowledge with the right person rather than telling people what to do. Everybody is capable of taking their own decisions if they have the right knowledge. So can we make the world more beautiful by sharing the right knowledge with the right people and making them feel empowered to take the right decision? Thank you so much, all of you, for showing up. My lives begin at 9 and end at 9:30. And I take the right decision at the right time always, and I empower you to take the right decision at the right time by providing you with simplified knowledge. I'll be very happy to get your questions on laser hair reduction, and I will wait for more questions, because again, Thursday we are talking about laser hair reduction. This is called Ask Me Anything About Laser Hair Reduction. Get all your questions answered and make the right decision. Thank you so much. I'm looking forward to see you Thursday, 9 o'clock. Bye-bye.